Now, as we turn our attention to the forecast, here is a live look from downtown Chattanooga. We are loving those clear blue skies. Let's find out how many more lie ahead. Hey, Paul.
Cindy, we're going to have just a few clouds move in late tonight and through the maybe in the morning hours. And I think we're going to see some breaks in the clouds. Once again, jet stream still roaring out of the northwest. It's kept us fairly cool, but, you know, the sun is really doing its thing right now. So it's the sun fighting what the cold air coming in at the same time. So we're about near normal. That's where temperatures are, pretty much in the low 70s. Now, for tomorrow, we're still going to have winds out of the west-northwest, and a cold front's going to pass, but the winds are going to be really picking up for tomorrow. Right now, there's a little thunderstorm over the Ozarks in southern Missouri that's severe. It could have some hail, some gusty winds, but just some scattered showers through St. Louis generally. All the heavy-duty rains moved out to sea. See where all that lightning is? That's where all the big thunderstorms were that were south of us yesterday. And again, looking at the clouds, you can see some of these thunderstorms starting to pop up over the Ozarks as they move towards the west. I think they'll fade out here. Air is very dry right now in the Tennessee Valley. Dew points are low, 74 right now in the city, 72 Cleveland, Athens, Dayton, and also in Dalton. Murphy's at 68, and winds out of the west-northwest at 8. Pollen count today was only 27. That was taken this morning. I bet you it's a little higher right now. 74, 53 for the high and the low. And about 9/10 of an inch of rain fell at the airport. You had yesterday's on top of that, and we get about an inch and a quarter or so. About an inch and a third fell, and these are two-day totals from Sky Watchers, 1.3 in Dalton, also in Calhoun, 1.6 Chatsworth and Lafayette, almost an inch and a half for Somerville to Scottsboro, about almost an inch and a half out near Cleveland, 1.6 Ootowa, 1.4 out near East Ridge, and about an inch and a third from Lookout all the way to Trenton, and some places less than an inch, especially right around the city or so. And then about an inch and a half up near Pikeville, 1.6 Spring City, and 10 Mile, 1.4. Turtle Town had an inch, a little more than an inch, downtown Murphy, 1.2 out near Jasper, with 8/10, Kegel Mountain, Dunlap, and 1.2 again in Jasper. All right, looking at the Vipercast tomorrow, that little wave of moisture is going to be moving, maybe just clipping some of our northern counties, so you may see a sprinkle or two up there. Then the cold front comes in, winds will really be picking up out of the west and northwest. And here's our next batch of rain. This is Wednesday morning. It's still off to the west. Into Wednesday afternoon, I think it holds off, maybe a sprinkle before then. But here's the heavier rain coming in on Thursday. Could have a thunderstorm with this too. We'll keep an eye on it. Right now, Storm Prediction Center says we will not get severe weather on Thursday, but, you know, there's thunderstorms, so we still could get a thunderstorm or two. And then coming up into Thursday afternoon and evening, it pushes off to the east, and we start to dry off until the weekend when we get some more on Saturday. Right now, quite a bit of rain could fall on Thursday. I'm thinking at least an inch to an inch and a half of rain. Tonight, 50 with a few clouds moving in late, light winds. 75 tomorrow after a few morning clouds, the sun comes back, 75. It's going to be breezy, though, with westerly winds 15 to 20 and gusty. And then tomorrow night, 45 with clear skies, light winds. So that's just a little below normal. 7-day forecast, breezy again tomorrow with 75. 70 on Wednesday with those showers moving in late at night. And then on Thursday, good chance for rain, maybe a storm. Nice Friday, not so nice Saturday, and cooler Sunday and into Monday. Cindy?
All right, Paul, thank you.